What is up, guys? Today we're taking a look at MacWrite, the original word processor released with the 1984 Macintosh. Along with its sister program, MacPaint, MacWrite was developed essentially so that the Macintosh would have usable programs the day that it launched. Like many of the aspects of the original Macintosh, for me, it's not surprising how outdated it seems, but how modern it is. Really, a user today could sit down in front of MacWrite and be able to use it effectively. In fact, the menu items and shortcut keys really aren't that different from the ones we see today. In fact, the biggest thing a modern user might notice is simply the limited number of options for things such as font and text size, which is really more indicative of the computing power of the 80s than it is about the software limitations. And speaking of fonts, MacWrite came with 7, each named after a city that their design was reminiscent of. Much like the Apple-made apps of today, interoperability was a key feature. It was simple to copy and paste from MacPaint into MacWrite. And while this may sound pretty basic by today's standards, this was a big deal as this was the dawn of the what you see is what you get text editor. A good point of comparison is this. This is the interface for WordStar, the most popular word processing program when MacWrite was first released. I think it's important to note that MacWrite wasn't the first what you see is what you get style word processor, but it definitely had a massive impact on those that came after it. It did, however, also have some major flaws, the biggest of which was probably its 10-page limit. Now, this is due to the limited 128K of memory in the original Macintosh. This was improved upon by not only later versions of MacWrite, but most notably by Microsoft Word. And it was because of third-party developers like Microsoft that both MacPaint and MacWrite outlived their initial purpose. Apple was slow to issue updates for the software and eventually transferred all the rights to its spin-off company, Claris, who did issue new versions of the software into the early 90s. However, by then, Microsoft Word was becoming the de facto standard in word processing, and that was the death of MacWrite. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. I'll see you next time.